I believe there are two types of chefs. The chef that spent 24 hours a day in the kitchen, not having personal life, not having anything else than kitchen. And the chef that is a cool chef, personality, and more business oriented. So all my life I was the first case. So I was in the kitchen all day cooking. And at one point I believe something happened in my life and I say, you know what, I want to be the creator. I want to be the chef that is creative and can be able to conceptualize different kinds of venues, different kinds of concepts, cuisines, and be on that pattern. So I took all my experience, I took all the contacts that I created, and I took all the knowledge and launched my own company. It was called Ares Hospitality Consultants. Obviously, in hospitality, working as a chef, it generates a lot of stress. So I look forward to the weekend. So I started swimming. It's just fantastic. It's exactly what I need, you know, to disconnect from the phone, to disconnect from the business calls, to disconnect from the busy environment that I'm usually working with. I'm just under the water, thinking of my own things. I finish that, I take another 10, 15 minutes to meditate, to think about my day, what is gonna happen, what things I need to do, to project what things I wanted to happen, to pray, which is a big part of my daily routine as well. As I believe every passion back up with faith, it might be soon a success, a reality. Well, you know, everything started when I was quite young. My father used to be the one cooking at home. So for me, the presence of a man in the kitchen was quite normal and I was used to it. I told my parents, listen, I don't want to go to university. I don't want to do anything else than cooking. So I want to be a chef. Immediately they say, there is no way. I'm not going to support that. They are not going to support that career. And I told him, I'm not going to be a simple cook. I'm going to be the best chef in the world. And we went to look for different schools of culinary schools. So the journey started there, I believe, when I was 19 years old. Being the sous chef of a top 5 restaurant in Lima, I had everything, right? So I had a girlfriend, I had a car, I had my family, I live with my parents, and I have a very good job. And that's when I learned about the comfort zone, right? So how important it is to move from your comfort zone. Since that time, I start putting in my mind what I really want to achieve. It needs to be in my mind on a constant basis, every single day. So I resigned from my job. I broke up with my girlfriend, I sold my car, and I told my parents. But that's one decision that I took that changed my whole life. I met a chef, very popular, called Richard Sandoval. Somebody told me that he is looking for chefs to open a restaurant in Dubai. I did my research, and I found a 7-star hotel. I found the tallest building in the world. I say, what is this? Where is this place? You know, take me now. I went to the interview and we made click and we came to Dubai. We love the city, you know, how developed it was, how modern it was. The metro, it looked like a spaceship, you know, like it was crazy. It was a whole discovering process. At that point, we opened a massive restaurant, the biggest restaurant I opened in my life, called Toro Toro. It was a team of almost 30 people in the kitchen, 500 covers on a daily basis. So I believe that was the biggest learning that I had from Richard Sandoval. And then I started feeling like the sensation to want more. So I say, okay, I'm going to build my own project. So I hired a designer. I told them all my ideas, what I have in mind. I told them the name, the logo, the look and feel, et cetera, et cetera. And I create a business plan. So by the end of 2020, my company was more established. We have been doing amazing concepts and we are always on the research and on looking for how to help and how to create unique experiences. Because hospitality today is about the mix of everything and the experience that you can offer to a customer. You know what, as a professional chef, you always have this feeling of being strong in the kitchen, being strong with the staff, with the family that you have, because I have two families, right? One in the restaurants and one at home. One side, consistency, standards, and discipline is the most important part of a success. On the other side, which is in my house, is all about my heart. I found a different approach to see the things. So in my case was que leave your professional career one time on the side and dedicate to your family. I've been married now for 10 years and suddenly my wife got pregnant after a trip to Italy. So my son was born, his name is Luca. And since then I got a new best friend. I discovered that I love to be a father. Obviously as any kid is all around the place, but he's so smart, he's so sweet. I look at him and I see how in defense he can be, right? How exposed he is to the world. The most important thing for me is to teach him things, not to tell him to don't do things, tell him do it, but you know, this might happen. And he sees me cooking. So now he's very interesting about cooking. So he does his pizza, his square, it's all terribly done, but I say it's amazing. I don't want anything else other than to be in my house with my kid, with my wife, and now with my new integrant, the princess of the house. And Luca is taking the responsibility of the big brother. He wants to feed her, he wants to change her, he wants to do that. Obviously, we don't let her yet because he's very fragile. And to be honest, I'm very grateful for that. I'm very grateful for that opportunity. And I'm grateful for Dubai as well because Dubai gave us that opportunity to be able to spend time, you know, together. And the motivation behind to finish work 1 hour early just to go and see him before he sleeps is priceless. The city is growing so fast. Everyone wants to grow so fast that everyone is, you know, giving it all. And it took me so many times to do it. But it teach me that if in life, if you want things to happen, you should treat it as a business plan. So you need to have a plan in base for anything that you want to achieve. So even if it's something personal or if something professional, put it on a plan, make your calculations, make your projections, see how much money you need to achieve to make it happen. And before you realize it, it will happen.